Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijer, a retired lecturer in hermetology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Recently, FGM, female mutilation, you know, this genital mutilation, what you call it, is coming into light that the circumcision has been extended to women, and by doing so, people are getting mad, because this circumcision was a tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac only. As I lived in Africa, over there they have tribal marks on their faces. By looking at the man, you can tell him that man belonged to this tribe, that tribe, so and so. So you don't need to ask him. By his face, you can tell. And that man knows that the other person knows who I am. So he would not deceive him. Or if the person is of a nature, you know, of deceiving type, then the other person is warned, you know, that, oh, don't trust him, you know, he's a thief. Like in Ghana, you know, over there, the Fra-Fra people, northern Fra-Fra people, they were known to not honest people. They will steal, you know, if you employ them as laborer or anything, they try to steal. So they were well known, you know, by when you employ a Fra-Fra, then you know that you are looking for a thief. And if you warn him, you know, some of them are good and they work hard. But once they know, you know, that you know their characteristic, and they also get alert and they will try to be honest to you. So this tribal mark of Abraham is to Isaac and his seed. Anybody born of the seed of Isaac, he is entitled to circumcision. Not born of the daughter of Isaac, because daughters don't carry seed, only the men carry seed. But when Jesus came, they were even, you know, making Gentiles the sons of Abraham through circumcision. And Abraham told them to stop this malpractice. They were trying to make money. More members of the congregation, more money to please people. So Abraham pointed out that our forefather Stephen, you know, Angel Stephen, when he was called to temple, he pointed out to them that our forefather Abraham was a nobleman and keep his seed pure. Don't make people of other tribes to be sons of Abraham. And that he was killing their business, and they were grinding their teeth to kill him because they want money. That matters to them, not the moral laws. That's why he was angel, not a saint. John the Baptist was an angel. So that's why Angel Stephen was killed by the Jews for stopping their business, you know, of making sons of Abraham through circumcision. They were making rather Jews. And I don't know how their circumcision went among the Mohammedan, because Mohammedan, they are Gentile, and they were people of Ishmael. They were not circumcised, because he was not the real son of Abraham. So maybe when these Hazrat Muhammad Sahib, he promoted his Islam, then the Jewish people entered into his clan, entered into his business. And when they entered into the business, they bring in this the Moses, because Moses is one of their prophets. So they bring in his practice of circumcision, and it is wrong. In people from India, they belong to Aryan race. They are not Semitic race. How could they be sons of Abraham? Just think about it, you know. This is a madness of religion. And this FGM is also a utter madness. I've written something, and here it is. This physical body is the perfect art of Yahweh, called Brahma or Khudah. Kudrat Khudaili, Noor Allah. That means Noor, light, is of Allah. This Kudrat, nature, is of Khudah. If such a circumcision was required or essential, our Heavenly Father Yahweh would have got it done already in the womb of our mothers, as there is no imperfection in his creation or in his art. However small you can take a little insect, you know, you will find his art, our Heavenly Father's art, in that insect is perfect, does not need any changes. In fact, circumcision is the tribal mark or covenant of Abraham with Isaac and his generation by his seed. No one else is allowed this circumcision, but the temple priest was catching Gentiles and through circumcision turning them into the Jews outwardly are the sons of Abraham. Remember, Christ Paul, he brings somebody to the temple to be circumcised and to go through all these rituals so that the temple priest may be happy to see that he bring a prey for them. So they don't be angry with him, you know. How could a person from India of Aryan race become a son of Abraham, a Semitic? Angel Stephen pointed out this malpractice for the sake of Mammon. They were doing it for the sake of Mammon. And the temple priests started grinding their teeth with anger to kill him, which they did as to Jesus and St. James the Just as well. Remember that the Jews, by killing the most just man in the world, Jesus, sowed the seed of terrorism, and as you would not allow even your neighbor to pluck the fruit of a tree that you have sown in your house, so the Jews are today getting bundled up in Israel to collect the fruit of the huge tree of terrorism, which they planted small one in by killing Jesus. It had become a huge tree, as stated in Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30, where the Heavenly Father Yahweh planted the good seed, wheat plant, sons of Adam, or sons of Abraham. But the Satan came and planted tares, making the Jews outwardly and saying bye-bye to their tribal fathers. And then what happens? That will bring the world to an end in the atomic war expected soon after Israel is 70 years old. No one can harm Israel till then, as the temple was destroyed in 70 AD and not earlier. Remember, the Sanhedrin members are 70, based upon 10 commandments and 7 type of works. 6 secular, the 1 spiritual, purely spiritual. which is middle candle of the menorah. So 7 times 10, 70. So 70 times 70, you know, were the years Jesus allowed them the temple. And then it was destroyed, not one brick left on top of the other. That means in the royal priest of Jesus, they do not have anything above them, because royal priest is the greatest, highest order. So these dog holder priests in the churches, they are nowhere near royal priest. They are even worse than those rabbis from which Jesus got rid by giving his own sacrifice, as is stated in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45. So you can see where you stand. They are these dog holder people. They are worse than those rabbis, and they are crook of the first degree. And that's why they are creating sectarian riots. And in the Middle East, people are dying because of these antichrists. From these chosen people, terrorists, were created terrorist pope. Pope started killing people. He was a terrorist. Muhammad, etc. And when such terrorism reached India, there the second coming of Jesus in the name of Nanak, Satguru Nanak, appeared to redefine the religious identities, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, etc. So he identified it, who is a Hindu, who is a Sikh, Muslim, and so. Thus a Hindu is one who knows his tribal identity are owned. Sikh is a student of spiritual knowledge, and a Muslim stands for a person with Muslim, firm like a baked brick. You have a raw brick, you know, clay, that will, when rain comes, you know, it will melt away. But if you bake it in the kiln, you get a baked brick, Muslim. And that won't melt away. If rain come, anything come, it will take it. It is building your house on rock. And Iman means faith in Allah. Thus a true Musliman has conscience, which they call it, in Arabic they call it Zamir, in Punjabi we call it Sharam, and in English they call it Shame. Called half Iman. Hazrat Muhammad has said it is half Iman, you know. It's the foundation. Truth. Should not tell lie. Truthful. Contented. Don't take somebody's property. As people were doing, you know, when they invaded a village or something, and they got the loot, and they will take it to their homes, which was not right, which is against contentment. And merciful, that means only you could be merciful if you are contented. If you are a greedy person, you won't be merciful. You will be cruel person. Such a Musliman or such a person is in Allah. If he submits himself to the will of our Father Allah, Al-Illah, called Inshallah, and not to the will of Mullahs, called Inshmullah, as it is today. Allah being the primary source of light, he is analogized to sun, while the Mullahs are rabbis, such as John the Baptist, ideal rabbi, to moon, a witness to the light, but not light. So the present Islam of Sharia is of the mullahs, because the sun, primary source of light, has no material thing. It is light. Light has not material. So it's energy. So it's free of Sharia, you know, sun. If Allah was, Sharia came from Allah, then Allah will be bound by that Sharia too, otherwise he will be a hypocrite. So Sharia is man-made, not made by Allah. Allah is spirit. So this is the Islam. Sharia is of the mullahs, or is mullahs of the sons of Satan. Anybody who stand between man and God, he is a son of Satan. These dog order priests, pope, mullahs, these granthis, all those are, you know, religious with the garb, they put on, they are all antichrist. That is why they are causing all these problems. Remember, Jesus said, I have come to do the will of my Father, Allah, and not my own will. The same was said by Nanak, Hukum Rzai Chalna, Nanak Likhya Naal. But the crook, clever people of arid spirit, arid evil spirit, Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, have become dominant as those who are sealed to serve God. They have become dominant, you know, and as those who are against those, you know, who are sealed to serve God, are themselves solitary, and they encourage others to become solitary, as no one can give your account to God but you yourself. I have written much more against the hypocrisy and religious communities. For example, these Mohammedans pray five times facing Kaaba, the temple of Adam. They know it. It's a temple of nothing, nothing to do with Allah, Adam. But in their kalma, they say La Illah, or La means forget about it. Ba means yes. La means no illah. That is why when they go to Hajj, you know, the mullah tell them, no, you are not to mention your tribal identity. You are not to say you belong to this tribe, that tribe, and this and that. But that Kaaba is to make you son of your tribal father. They are saying opposite to him, because they go around Kaaba with the left hand, not right hand. People should go like this, keeping Kaaba to the right, but they go to left, they keep it to the left, saying bye-bye to Christ, their Adam, you know, bye-bye to your tribal father. La illa. So that's why when they come out, then they don't mention their tribe. There are bastards born of the prostitutes. They don't know their tribe. They don't know who is their father. But these people, they know their father, and the mullah tells them, forget about them, making them super bastard fanatic devils. And that is what they are doing now. So what is the purpose of facing the temple of Adam, Kaaba, and saying that I do not believe in the sons of Adam? Remember, Jesus was the second floating Adam for the Jews, had become unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh by becoming Jews outwardly, of physical self, in which you say bye-bye to your tribal fathers such as Levi tribe, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe. You say bye-bye, I'm not your son. That's why when Jesus was sitting in the temple, in John 8, he told them, your forefathers were super bastard devils. Now the word super bastard, you know, they have removed it from the Bible. And when Jesus said so, then the Jewish people said, we are not born of legitimate parents. We have our father and mother. We are not born of fornication. He said what you say is true, but when you say you are a Jew outwardly, you say bye-bye to your tribal father. You become spiritually super bastard, spiritual bastard, fanatic. As these Mohammedans say in La Illah. So one fanatic devils, The Jews have produced another fanatic devils to create a proper mess in the world. That is why in Revelation it is mentioned those who will be saved are 144,000. That would be saved are all mentioned by their tribal identities, Judah tribe, Levi tribe, not as Jews. Jews, they will die. Sikh, Hindu, Muslim, they will die. Tribal people will be saved. Wheat plants are the tribal people, and not Hindu, Sikh, Muslim or Jews, the tares that are supposed to burn each other, sectarian riots, during this ensuing sectarian and atomic war. Tribal people among the African and Amazon jungles will survive to carry on with the next generations of humanity. Our Father Allah blesses those who do His will, the solitary, because this is the age of solitary, you know, it's no more the age of going after those blind guides and become blind. When the blind man guide leads the blind, they fall into the pit of sectarian riots or Holocaust, as the Jewish people in Germany recently fell. You cannot blame Hitler for the deaths of the Jews, but the Jews themselves, as this tree of terrorism, which they planted the seed in their house in Israel 2,000 years ago by killing Jesus. Now it has become a huge tree. Now they are the one brought back into Israel to reap the fruit of that huge tree of fanaticism. So they will meet fanaticism, you know. And if you understand these things, you know, it's very interesting. And your heart will be full of joy, because that is what gospel stands for. Good news, which you books can't give you. You receive it through revelation, through logical reasoning. Reason logically and you get logos. Logo is His word. Our Father God blesses you.